Hi everyone, so today we'll discuss about metrology and some basic and fundamental concepts associated with it. So let us start with what exactly the metrology is. So the word metrology is made up from two Greek words. So first is metro and the second logy. So this metro is nothing but measurements and logy is science. So this metrology can be defined as it is a science of measurements. Science of measurement is itself is a very huge field. You can observe surrounding different applications like automotive applications, applications related to electronics and telecommunication, computer related applications, construction, buildings. Everywhere as an engineer you have to make use of this metrology. So what is the ultimate purpose of this metrology? So metrology helps to maintain a quality. So this word metrology is often used with metrology and quality engineering, metrology and quality control. So how it can be done? See, if the components manufactured is of high accuracy, then definitely this will affect system performance. See, this accurate components will perform very well in system and system will show very high effectiveness and efficiency, and hence this metrology and quality control is of high importance or is given very high importance in industry. In industry also, you will be having a separate department, quality control department, where you will be having ample of opportunities to work as an engineer. So in this metrology and quality engineering lectures, we will study different units, measuring instruments, measuring procedures, different standards and many other parameters related to this metrology and science of measurements. So let us move towards some basic and fundamental concepts associated with it. So here I am starting with the very basic parameters, and the first parameter is workpiece. It can also be called as component. What is it? Anything which is fitted in an assembly system can be called as components. For example, these two are components. You can take example of automotive engine, piston, cylinder, crankshaft. Everything. Automotive car is made up of 1000+ components. So after manufacturing of these parts or components, this need to be measured to maintain a specific accuracy. And for measuring purpose, we should have a specific instrument. There are varieties of instrument available. If I am drawing a line, I am measuring a line of 10 mm, then I am measuring it with a measuring scale, then this can be called as instrument. If you observe in industry where they have maintained precision machineries in very high-end atmosphere, means space or atmosphere without dirt, then specific humidity and at specific temperature level, obviously a very high accurate measurements are carried out on that machine. So it depends on what type of components you are measuring and what level of accuracy is desired in that particular application. For example, if I have to measure this diameter, then I need not to make use of very high end or precision instrument to measure this diameter. This diameter can be simply measured with a simple instrument. Okay, but if you can say there are some components of weighing scale that can be used to weigh gold, in that case, yes, accuracy is of very high importance. For that, you may use some high precision machineries or instruments to measure the different dimensions. So according to these workpieces and applications, you have to select proper instrument. Then the next component is obviously operator. Operator is basically a person who is handling the measurements. If I am measuring the diameters of this component measured, then I am an operator. So operator, here also you'll find that there are skilled operators and unskilled operators, because if I have to simply measure these diameters, then I need not to be have very skilled. Okay, right? But if I wanted to handle that tool room that I have talked about, which is used in industry, then yes, the labor should be skilled and likewise this operator will be paid. The next parameter is calibration. So calibration is the process of measuring accuracy of instrument. So it is related to the instrument, not related to the workpiece or component. Means when a specific instrument is used to measure thousands of components, then there is a possibility that instrument will not give accurate results. For example, I am having one instrument. See, this is a vernier caliper. that I am going to explain in next lectures. So for example, see, you'll find the scale is here. So consider this is a component that I have manufactured. Then I have to measure maybe this side. So for example, if this is a 10 mm, then when I am measuring the first component, then there is a possibility that I can get reading as 10.0001 mm. Okay, but when I am measuring thousandth of component, then there is a possibility that I'll be getting 10.1, means the results will not be accurate. So this is what is the reason. See, every time when I touch these jaws to the components, there is a possibility that these jaws will be worn out. So in that cases, after specific interval, I have to compare this instrument with the standards, high quality standards, and accordingly I have to little bit modify this instrument to maintain again to set according to the standard, so that again I'll be getting an accurate results. So this is required for all the instruments at specific intervals. So now we'll move towards the next component, which is stability. So stability is again related to this point or this parameter, calibration. So stability, it is an ability of instrument to retain calibration. Means if I am having two instruments, then one instrument need to be calibrated after 6 months, and this instrument need to be calibrated after a year. Means this instrument is having a better ability to retain its calibration, because once a year only calibration is required. Here twice a year calibration is required. So this instrument can be considered as more stable. And the next parameter, sensitivity. So sensitivity is again related to the instrument, sensitivity or instrument. So as I said, so first time when I am measuring this side, then there is a possibility that I can get, even though this side is of 10 mm, I may get 10.0001, because it is practically impossible to get exact 10 mm. There will be a little bit variation. Okay, first time I'll get 10.0001, but second time I'll not exactly get 10.0001. There will be a little bit of variation. I may get 10.00002. So there will be a little bit variation, and that is nothing but sensitivity of that particular instrument. If I am having two instruments, so in one instrument I am getting a little bit variation, and another instrument I am getting considerable variation, then we can say the sensitivity, this instrument, first instrument, is more sensible. Now the next parameter is list count. It can also be called as resolution. For example, consider this side is of exactly 10 mm, but if I am measuring with this instrument, I may get 10.001. so this 001 is considered as least count of this specific instrument. I mean, this is basically at what accuracy this instrument can measure the dimension, is called as least count. And then the next parameter, range or span. This is again related to the instrument. So this is the region for which this instrument is designed to measure minimum value and maximum value. So for example, if this instrument is designed to measure minimum value of 10 mm and maximum value of 100 mm, then this 10 to 100 is called as range or span of this instrument. So accordingly, according to different instruments, this range or span will be different. So now moving toward the workpiece or component, there is a parameter called as true value or actual value, or true size or actual size. As I have already mentioned, it is practically impossible to manufacture the component with a specific size. Means, for example, if this side is 10 mm, so it is impossible to exactly manufacture the component with 10 mm, right? So true size is nothing but the theoretical dimension of a workpiece or component. However, actual size is the size or dimension which is actually manufactured. So there will be a variation. Maybe if the true size is 10 mm, then the actual size I may get is 10.001 mm. Now the next parameter is repeatability. See, these two parameters are very important, repeatability and reproducibility. So to understand this repeatability, you have to assign 1000 components to a single operator and you have to tell him that he has to measure all these 1000 components with the help of single instrument. And then we have to observe whether the results coming are close together. For example, this side is of 10 mm length, then for first dimension I'll be getting 10.001, for second 10.002, 10.003, all these values are close together. Then you can say this instrument is having repeatability, means ability to repeat the result or closeness of results. So now we'll move towards reproducibility. See, to understand this, you have to assign, see, I have to measure this dimension 20 times and for that I have to assign this job or this workpiece to three operators, okay, and we have to tell them that they have to measure this dimension, maybe with the help of single instrument or by using different instruments, and then you have to observe the readings. If the readings are coming close together, then those results can be called as reproducibility, or these results can be reproducible. So now we'll turn toward the next parameter, which is interchangeability. See, for standardization, this parameter is again very important. Interchangeability is the ability of component to get replaced. For example, if there is a problem in any system, I will be capable to replace that particular component. Okay, otherwise I may need to replace whole system, that should not be there. So interchangeability should be there in any system. So these are some basic and fundamental parameters that I feel you should know before moving towards the lecture series of this metrology. So in next lecture we'll discuss different types of standards, maybe primary, secondary and tertiary.